is known as a cancer site that benefits from having what we call a multidisciplinary approach. So you want specialists from all the various disciplines of medicine coming together as a team, making a decision about what is the best management for this patient. My role here at Sibley Radiation Oncology is to treat patients that have cancer with radiation treatment. For sarcoma, that is often used in combination with surgery or other therapies. The first step before we can start radiation is to do a planning session, what we call a simulation, because we're often simulating what the treatment is going to be. What becomes important with the simulation session is getting the patient in the best position possible to be able to target that tumor but protect everything else around it. Generally, it takes about 1 to 2 weeks to create that treatment plan, and then the patient would come back to begin their daily radiation treatment course, which usually runs for about 5 to 7 weeks. We have multiple forms of radiation treatment. The most common form of radiation is X-ray radiation, or what we call photons. There's another form of external radiation, which is called proton therapy or particle therapy. We can strip a proton from the atom and actually target that particle to the tumor target. So sarcomas are known to invade the adjacent areas or the areas around them. You can think of maybe a tree with roots. When we give the radiation treatment, it's causing what we call a consolidation, bringing in those roots or those areas that are invading and bringing them closer to the tumor and creating the shell or what we call a rind. So radiation is helping us make sure that the surgeon, when he or she is indeed removing the tumor, they're getting all of that tumor out. The treatment itself is usually the fastest part. It may be 5 minutes or, 10 minutes, depending on how complex the area is we're treating. You don't feel anything, you don't see anything, there's no pain, it doesn't hurt, it doesn't burn. There's no immediate effect to treatment. In fact, sometimes patients say, is anything even happening? Did anything happen? Or that was it. The way I think of radiation sometimes is we're giving a hit each day, a gentle hit each day, that's enough to kill cancer cells, but try not to irritate too much those surrounding tissues. That's why it takes so long. We could actually get through the treatment faster, but then you're really giving a harder hit that could cause more damage or irritation to the surrounding tissues. You're gonna see some skin reaction eventually, and sometimes it can look like a sunburn. Usually the first week or two you don't notice much. The third or fourth week you might start to notice a little bit of that pinkness or redness or tanning coming in. Very often just a simple, plain lotion will be more than enough. By the time you get to surgery, most of the peak of that redness or tanning or darkness is generally gone away. You might notice it a little bit like a sunburn, takes a little bit of time to fade away. In the post-operative setting, it's a little bit different when we do the radiation after surgery. If you have redness or tanning, eventually sometimes it can get a little bit of peeling like a sunburn, or even blistering or weeping. So the main risk is if there are areas that are open, it could be a risk for infection. So we might use topical creams that might have antibiotic, or even prescribe an oral antibiotic if we're concerned. And then there can be late side effects, things that can happen months to years down the road. The main risk are the areas around there are going to be a little bit weaker, the muscle, the soft tissue, the bone. Minimizing the long-term effects after surgery and radiation is to encourage that physical therapy after treatment. Once the patient's done with treatment, we definitely want to make sure that we are coordinating that follow-up, or what we call survivorship care, now that you're into this period of survivorship. The cancer has been hopefully eliminated, but we also want to pay attention. We want to keep close track. We need to do periodic imaging and scans and make sure that cancer has not come back. And we also want to check in on the side effects, any of the late or long-term side effects of treatment, and what can we do to promote the healing.